titled it as Idea to Impact, because many times I have heard people of, and young people also, by the way, not just my age and older one, they say, "Is idea mein kya rakha hai?" I had thought about it 10 years back. Maybe Facebook idea, or maybe the your Elon Musk, your transporter idea, or whatever it is. People said, "Nah, ye toh maine socha tha 10 saal pehle." I said, "So what's the use of that? Agar Mark has gone ahead or Elon has gone ahead, you're not gone ahead, you're not made money, you're not created the jobs and economic impact and all those things." So ideas, I don't care about anymore. It's I care about people who take the run with the idea and take it all the way and do good for themselves and as well as people around them, society also there. If you look at most products, and I'm talking about, let's say, go out of India, let's say today. You go to Canada or New Zealand or South Africa, wherever it is, rest of the world. It is very difficult to find a product and say, "Aha, that is made in India, my India." You know, it's very difficult to find something made in India. In fact, if you see most of the things, they're all consumer products, you know, defense, you know, industrial machinery, even your medical devices, which I'll talk about a little later. 80%, 90% are imported. Now the question is, why can't we do it? Aren't we innovative enough? Okay. And if you look at India and Jugaad, or Jugaad and say, or Indian Jugaad, you will get plenty of ideas like this. Okay, you don't have a mirror, you want to shave, or you want to peel onions without getting tears. And even classical examples like, that is of course lassi making in a washing machine in the north. But also if you look at things like your truck tires on the bullock cart thing, which really improves its comfort level. And a very classical Jaipur leg, the bottom right picture is a picture of a Jaipur leg, which has now benefited 5 lakh people, poor people. There are no engineers, teachers, scientists involved. Some doctor and one craftsman together just created a methodology for creating a leg, artificial leg for people who have amputations. 5 lakh people benefited, no scientists involved. So there is a lot of creativity involved, available in the country. It's a question of why we are not able to harness that. And there I come with my theory of what I call as valleys of death. Valleys of death, literally, okay? As I said, ideas, no big deal. Anyone has, a lot of people have ideas. If you and me sit together next half an hour, we can create next 100 ideas in the next half an hour. Trust me. This room, we can create 1,000 new ideas we can do in the next, let's say, couple of hours. Not a big deal, okay? The issue is creating what is called as a proof of concept. Idea sitting in your head. No one will put a money on the table and say, "Here is what I have in mind." Something to show the person. If it's electronic, create a breadboard thing. If it's software, create a PowerPoint. PowerPoint screenshot of how your app will look like, what input, outputs. If it's a mechanical product, build something with clay or some basic mechano sets and things like that. Something which can give an idea and explain to the person in front of you, "This is what I have in mind." Proof of concept. From there you go to next step, which is called prototype, which is an actual reasonably working prototype. It's not something which you can still sell it in the market, but something which works. You can 3D print, you can do a PCB printing, you can do some app development and create something. "This is what I have in mind. This is a scientific principle. This is how it will work. In this way, it will be better than something which is existing right now." That is your prototype, okay? From there, there's one other value of death, is to make a product. Now, product means not necessarily you're making a million pieces. Maybe you're making 10 pieces, 20 pieces, 50 pieces. Because you need to show it to the first few people who want to say, "Oh, this is very good, I would like to buy it." Or someone says, "This is very good, I would like to market that or distribute that." Or some investor says, "Oh, this is good, here is 50 lakh rupees, and go to the next step." Okay, once you cross these three valleys of death, the next one actually is business, which is regular business where you do a startup company and then you scale up. You have all kinds of funding, angel funding, venture funding, series A, B, C, D, all those things, if you heard about. And the problem starts with the mindset that usually what we think is that if you have got an idea, 40% job is there, done. What is there in selling a product? The 10% is for manufacturing and selling, right? In terms of value, 40, 30, 20, 10. Only when you try to go and sell something personally, go and buy a book and try to sell it at a profit to someone else, not your friend, a stranger. Okay? Then you realize the importance and difficulty of selling something. So really the equation actually is the other way around. Idea is, okay, converting idea into POC, POC to prototype, prototype to product, product to a viable business is what is takes a lot of effort and time. It is not even 10, 20, 30, 40, it's actually an order of magnitude higher than every stage. You can build a POC for a few thousand rupees. Prototype, maybe tens of thousand rupees, maybe a lakh or a few lakh rupees. Product, lakhs of rupees, millions of rupees, and business, crores of rupees. So actually 10 times more difficult as you go from the first one to last valley of death. The reason why it doesn't happen in academic institutions is that most faculty, and this is true for IIT Bombay also, I have many colleagues who say, oh, I just want to do research, don't disturb me about teaching, I don't want to go into industry, I just want to research only. There's some people who are excellent teachers who say, I just want to do teaching, don't give me research and all these other jobs. But the trick is not in that, trick is in connecting all the four. The question is, where do you start? And like Abhimanyu's Chakravyuh, there's only one right place to start. And the right place is not in our offices and labs and, in your case, your classrooms and your labs and your hostels. No. The real thing is real life. Go out to a farm or a factory or a hotel or a hospital. Go and see real life. Talk to the people. Ask them, look at a surgery, and I'll show you pictures of that. Okay? And ask the doctor, are you facing any difficulty? Do you have any ideas to improve this instrument or diagnostic or something like that? Okay? And what I tell teachers is, once you do that, go back and tell about it in your classroom. I always, these days mobile phones are very powerful. You can always take nice photos and videos and all those things. So I shoot videos all the time. Whenever I travel and see something interesting, take a video of that, a photograph of that, come back and show in the classroom and tell the students, this is what I saw last weekend. So I show this slide to teachers and tell them, don't say like that. Tell them, even if you know it is difficult and impossible and someone has done it, tell them it's a great idea. Should they be lying like this to students? There's a great advantage in doing that. Okay? And this I learned with the hard lessons in my life. You cannot be successful in business unless you have failed a few times. Let me repeat. Failure is the foundation for success. I even say failure is the key to success. Celebrate failure. The trick is in not failing and doing the same failure again and again, same. That is foolish. Fail in different ways, fail as inexpensively as possible, not catastrophic failure. And if you saw the previous valley of death slide, failure in early stages is very cheap. You make a clay model, okay, some doctor doesn't like it. What is your loss? A clay and some time, half an hour, maybe auto to go to the hospital, nothing much. If you fail at a second, third, fourth stage, if you fail after the device reaches the market and let's say 1 lakh people have taken the device, let's say medical device, and the device fails catastrophically, people are dying or asking for going to court with cases, that is catastrophic failure. So early failures is very good because you learn a lot from that. So I tell the teachers, let the students fail in small ways because that teaches you a lot of things. Okay. And then of course, try the idea and then test it. And if you keep doing it again and again, that is what I call as golden spiral. It's very powerful. Keep doing it again and again and again. After you do the final thing, go back to the doctor or hotel or hospital I told you and tell them this is what our students have done. I also ask a student to go and tell that. If the person says, this is a great idea, let me make dosas with this, fantastic, you can start a new business. If the guy says, no, this is a horrible thing, I have tried something similar, you got a feedback, market feedback. And you can go back and improve it further.